We are reading from sixth canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, chapter 16, entitled King Chitraketu Meets the Lord. And the text for today is text 35. So, sixth canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, Srila Prabhupada named the sixth canto prescribed duties for mankind. So, what are the prescribed duties for the mankind? Jivera Swarupa Krishna and Nitya Das. The prescribed duty is devotional service. And those who are performing devotional service, they are protected by Lord, they are maintained by Lord, they are cared by the Lord. So sixth canto, according to the reciprocation of the Lord, is called Poshan. Of the 10 subject matter of Bhagavatam is called Poshan, which means Lord nourishes his devotees when devotees are in distress. So what we are discussing right now, after Vritasura and Indra has a battle, and Vritasura, though having a devotion within his heart, is speaking wonderful prayers to the Supreme Lord, was defeated by Indra. Then with surprise, Parikshit Maharaj asked this question, who was that Vritasura? How come a demon have so deep devotion? And then answer to that, Sukhdev Goswami is narrating the King Chitraketu's pastime. So this is the continuity of Bhagavatam like that. So we know King Chitraketu, first he had a blessing by Angira Rishi came to enlighten him, but usually people in this world, they get material benefit first. And saintly person think, okay, now I can bless him whatever he wants, then he will have a faith and then I can instruct him in spiritual matters also. So he gave him blessing for his son, and then after that son died because of the enviousness of the queens, and Chitraketu was lamenting, and then Angira did not come alone, he came along with Narada. So really we have to go to preach, we go two, then the result will be good. If you go one, then it's no good result. Angira went one and there was a continuity of things going on with Chitra. When they went two, the result is very good. I think Srila Prabhupada said preachers should always go at least two, but Panchatattva proved the five is the best. Yeah? Panchatattva are five together, they were chanting. So it is better to go in association for preaching. So Narada, after bringing the child back, and when child spoke the real philosophy of the soul, and then Chitraketu was initiated by Narada Rishi. And then a wonderful mantra which he chanted in his, I think 16 verse or something, which is Sankarshanaya Namaha, Anuridhaya Namaha, Pradyumnaya Namaha, Vasudevaya Namaha, something wonderful. And he chanted that mantra for 1 week only. And Supreme Lord Nilambar Balaram appeared before him. So he had a darshan of the Supreme Lord. So his chapter is Chitraketu meets the Lord. By Lord's mercy, Lord appeared before Chitraketu. And then Chitraketu for a while was in a sort of astonishment and could not speak words, and then he started. After seeing Lord, he was offering prayers to the Lord. So yesterday in his prayers, Chitraketu said, "You are unconquerable, but you can be conquered by the devotees." So today we are reading this verse in which Chitraketu is glorifying the opulences of the Lord, or the Vaibhav of the Lord, Vaibhav Vibhuti, or the opulences. So let us recite this verse 35. Tava vibhava khalo bhagavan jagad udya sthiti laya dini vishwa srajaste ansa anshasa तत्मृषा स्मृदन्ति पृथिग् अभिमत्या तव विभव खलो भगवन् जगदुद्या स्थिति लयादिने विश्वसृजस्ते अंशान् शास् तत्र मृषा स्प्रदन्ति पृथिगभिमत्या तव विभवः खलो भगवन् जगदुद्या स्थिति लयादिने विश्वसृजस्ते अंशान् शास् तत्मृषा स्प्रदन्ति पृथिगभिमत्या तव युवर विभव ऑपुलेंसेस खलो इंडीड भगवान और सुप्रीम पर्सनालिटी ऑफ गॉड हेड जगत द कॉस्मिक मैनिफेस्टेशन Udya, creation. Sthiti, maintenance. Laya adini, dissolution and so on. Vishwa srajaha, the creators of the manifested world. Te, they. Ansha anshaha, parts of your plenary portions. Tatra, in that, mrsha, in vain, spradhanti, rival one another, prithik, of separateness, abhimatya, by the false conception. Translation purported by Srila Prabhupada ki. My dear Lord, this cosmic manifestation and its creation, maintenance and annihilation are all but your opulences. They are all your opulences. Which is the chapter of Bhagavad Gita, opulences of the Supreme? 10th. Okay? 10th chapter is opulences of the absolute. And which is the first verse of Chaturshloki Gita? Aham sarvasya parbhava mata sarvam pravartate. So what Krishna has said in Bhagavad Gita, just Chitraketu is repeating simply. Right? These are all your opulences. And from where he got this knowledge? By the mercy of Narad Rishi. And then he saw the Supreme Lord face to face. So what we have to learn, if we receive the transcendental knowledge through a bona fide parampara and we follow it properly, then definitely there is a time when we will see the light. It is Vyasadev similarly instructed by Narad Muni, then he went in Samadhi by Bhakti Yoga and see, he saw the Supreme Personality of Godhead with all his energies. Right? So to see Lord is by Lord's mercy. And Lord's mercy descends through his devotees. Therefore, the devotee of the Lord is called his divine grace, which means the Krishna Kripa Murti. He is the personification of the mercy of the Supreme Lord. So mercy of the Lord descends through his dear devotees, and by that we can understand the Lord and we can see the Lord through his opulences, which are in this material world. The opulences of the Lord are in this material world. And we are in this material world. So this is a process. Sri Gornitai ki, Sri Krishna Balaram ki, Sri Radha Shyam Sundar Lalita Vishakha Devi ki. So again, my dear Lord, this cosmic manifestation and its creation, maintenance and annihilation are all but your opulences. So these are the opulences of the Absolute. Creation, maintenance and annihilation. But, okay, since Lord Brahma and other creators are nothing but small portion of your portions of you, so there are other creators like Brahma, Prajapatis, they have also created, they are the progenitor of this whole, the progeny comes from the seven rishis and then Manus, so they are also creators. So what they are creator as your part, yes, as your part of your parts, portion of your portions. So they are also creator, but they are dependent on you. They are not independent of you. Their partial power to create does not make them God. Brahma is a creator, and the power given by Krishna to create, but he is not God. Honest, Brahma is so honest. In second canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, when Narada appeared before Brahma, he said, my dear father, well, this material creation is just like a walnut on your palm, amalika fruit on your palm. You can see it through, you made it. So you are the creator. But then Narada very politely said, but what, you are also doing meditation. So is there somebody above you? You are the creator, but why you are doing some meditation? Is somebody above you? And Brahma honestly said, yes. Only those who are bewildered by Supreme Lord's Maya think me creator. I am simply assembling something which is provided by Supreme Lord and intelligence given by Him. Tene Brahma Hirde Adi Kavya. It is the Supreme Lord who has given me intelligence and ingredients. I am simply following what He told me. So I am not the God. So Brahma, who is a creator, he says, I am not God. But those who are created, Brahma, they say, we are God. This is a foolishness. Brahma, who is creating, is a second creator. When Narada asked this question, he said, no, I am not creator. I am simply serving the Supreme Lord. But those who are created by Brahma and this planet, they are claiming to be God. That is actually foolishness. Chitraketu is exposing them. Okay? You are the... their partial power, means Brahma and others' partial power, To create does not make them creator or Ishwar. Their consciousness of themselves as separate lords, their consciousness of themselves as separate lord is therefore merely false prestige. It is not valid. But the word in Sanskrit is Sparda, competing. You have created this, I will create this. I will create better than you. And then in Christianity, there is a joke. They say, one scientist went to the Supreme Lord. He said, you are creating, we are also creating. So you create something, I will also create something. So God simply took some dirt and he said, let there be man. And he put the life and there is a man. And scientist said, I can create also. See, he's trying to take dirt. He said, make your own dirt. Don't take my dirt. Take your own dirt. Don't take my dirt. So how he creates? He don't have a dirt. He don't have an ingredient. How can he create? In one lecture, Srila Prabhupada was saying, my God brother from, I think, Japan or Germany, he says, scientists have so many miracles now that in space the matter is flying. So why should I try to become a yogi and have some mystic power which scientists are doing? I am here just to do the bhakti yoga because that is only the way now left for us. There is no other way. Avikalpena yogena. There is no other option left because scientists have already done something what yogis are doing. So why should I waste time in that? And so the only path left is now bhakti yoga that I am going to practice. So he came here and he was practicing. So Prabhupada was making point what the yogis are doing. Scientists have already invented so many machines. Yogi fly, but the aeroplane can take 300 people and fly. Yogi can fly alone. So yogi wastes 20 years to fly and here only 20,000 rupees and you fly. So why to waste time to become yogi? So Chitraketu here is describing, he's offering prayer actually to the Supreme Lord Balaram. Because actually he is creator. Krishna. He initiated the process, but he's not actively involved in creation. From his right side expands Balaramji, and from left side expands Radharani. So Balaram expands on right side, and his business is he helped Krishna in creation by five forms. Himself, to become everything for Krishna, as bed, as seat, as everything what Krishna uses. And three Purusha avatar, Karana Dakshaya, Garbha Dakshaya, and Kshira Dakshaya Vishnu. And fifth, as Anant Shesh, to hold this creation on his head. So this is the business of Balaram for creation actually. But through Sankrishan, after Balaram Sankrishan. So this is also teaching how to serve Krishna. Another side, Radharani expand, and then gopis, and then queens of the Dwarka and Lakshmis, they also teach us how to serve Krishna. Both way, they teach us how to serve Krishna. From Balaram's side, how through opulences we can serve Krishna. And through Radharani's side, how sweetness we can serve Krishna. So both ways we have to serve Krishna. But Balaram's side is through opulence, because creation is opulence and Vrindavan is only sweet relationship and simple living. So Radharani's side is giving us the service with a madhurya bhav, the loving relationship. Both ways service is there. And therefore Srila Prabhupada commends the Srishti Leela for the devotees as dear as Ras Leela. Srishti Leela is of Balaram and Ras Leela is of Radharani, and both are the primary expansion of Krishna. So both are equal for a Vaishnava. This is Prabhupada's comment. So this is what we Srishti Leela we are discussing right now. And both are dear to Vaishnavas. Because Srishti Leela is also Krishna. It is the opulence of the Krishna. And through opulence of the Krishna, we, in Hindi, they say, chamatkar ko namaskar hai. Chamatkar ko, opulence means chamatkar. Chamatkar, opulence means chamatkar. And namaskar means bow down. When there is some opulence, then automatically you bow down. Some foreigner, he entered into our Delhi temple museum, and when he saw a huge snake and Vishnu lying there, he said, "My God!" And somebody was said, "Yes," he said, "Yes, he is God. Yes, he is God. My God!" So he, this seeing the big snake was a surprising for him, and he said, "My God!" And the devotee says, "Yes, he is God." So opulence means that which remind you of God in material world. So who is the greatest opulence of Krishna? So first definition of opulence is one who reminds somebody of Krishna, that is the opulence of Krishna. Then who is the best opulence of Krishna in this world? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said that to the devotees of Kulin Gram. I'm giving you a hint. Devotee of Krishna is the greatest opulence. Who is devotee? Devotee is one by seeing him, you chant Hare Krishna. You see devotee going, oh Hare Krishna, people going. This is the greatest opulence. Directly, devotee remind the people of Krishna. This is the greatest opulence of Krishna actually. So the Chatur Shloki Bhagavad Gita is within 10th chapter. That is the real opulence of Krishna. The devotees and the reciprocation of Supreme Lord with devotees. This is the opulence in this material world to make us near to Krishna, to be more devoted to Krishna. Other opulences just make us bow down. But this opulence of devotee make us devotee. So now let's see Srila Prabhupada. A devotee who has fully surrendered to the lotus feet of the Lord knows very well that the creative energy of the living entities from Lord Brahma down to the small ant exist because the living entities are part and parcel of Lord. So first line is devotee who has fully surrendered. So this verse from 7th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, Deviye Eshu Gunamai Mama Maya Durtaya. As long as somebody is under the influence of three modes of material nature, he cannot understand Krishna. So what is the process? Yemam prapadyante mayam etam tarantite. Though as soon as some surrender, he is immediately freed from the influence of external energy. So Srila Prabhupada, a devotee who is fully surrendered, it means devotee who is beyond three modes of material nature. And how one can go beyond three modes of material nature? Avibhicharena bhakti yogena sagunan samataite tana brahma bhuyaya kalpate. Only by pure devotional service. So Chitraketu has performed devotional service under the guidance of Narada Rishi. And Narada Rishi is a bhakti acharya. Acharya for bhakti. Even Vyasadeva is an acharya for Vedic literature, but he could not really complete his work without the help of the bhakti acharya Narada. Without instruction, he could not complete his work. Bhagavatam is a bhakti, it's a bhakti, bhagavat dharma. It came only by the instruction of Narada, and then Vyasadeva compiled this. So this is very interesting, that devotee, because he is beyond three modes of material nature, then he can understand that creator. Everybody has a creation power. We have a creation power. So this creation power is ultimately coming from Krishna. Devotee knows this, everything which we possess is coming from Krishna. That is the proper understanding of a devotee. Nothing exists in this world which is not connected with Krishna. What is Maya in Chatur Shloki Bhagavat? In Chatur Shloki, four verses of Bhagavat, what is called Maya? That which is not connected with Krishna is Maya. That which is not connected with Krishna is Maya. So everything is connected with Krishna. Whatever you have, good or bad. This is very interesting. Good or bad. It is ultimately coming from Krishna. Dimavaya, divavimav purusha lokena, divavimav sargav, devasura evacha. The creation of demons and creation of devotees is coming from me. So bad elements are also coming from Krishna, but according to their karma. Not he is forcing them to do something bad. So, this is the first thing we have to understand. Whatever the talents we have, whatever the intelligence we have, it is coming from Krishna. That is the sign a devotee has surrendered to Krishna through parampara. If he thinks I am doing something, he is in Maya. I have created this thing, Maya. Very simple. Therefore, Srila Prabhupada created this whole ISKCON, but he said, no, I am not the founder. Krishna is the founder. This is the preface of Bhagavad Gita. People say, I am the founder of this ISKCON. No, I am not founder. Krishna is the original father of this. If I have any credit, that simply I try to fulfill the desire of my spiritual master. This is the humbleness of Srila Prabhupada. I have not created this. At other place, Srila Prabhupada said, well, this ISKCON, I have simply done this service on instruction of my spiritual master, so this is all his glories, not mine. So Srila Prabhupada, when he's writing something, he has his own personal realization. He's saying something which he himself has demonstrated in his own life. I am not creator of ISKCON. Krishna is the original father. And then he's speaking nectar of instruction. What he's saying? This ISKCON movement is conducted by under the supervision of Srila Rupa Goswami. He's not saying it is conducted under me. It's conducted under the supervision of Srila Rupa Goswami. So this is what we have to learn from this section of Bhagavatam, that credit has to go to Krishna through parampara. Never ever compete for credit or glory or something. That will immediately bring us in Maya. As soon as somebody do something and forget Krishna and think I have done, he is immediately in Maya. And this is the function of Maya, because then he wants to control Maya. There's no Krishna, so I should control Maya now. As soon as you just become little forgetful of Krishna's hand in everything, then you immediately feel, I am controller of this. This is my factory. This is my car. Creation of God has no problem. But creation of man has a problem. This glass is created by the metal, no problem. Drink water, drink milk. But man in anger take this glass and throw on somebody's head and there's a bleeding come. This is a problem. Misuse of the... You have... Home is not a problem. This is my home, don't come in this. This is a problem. Me and Maya is a problem, which is the creation of the living entity. But the creation of the Lord has no problem. There's a creation of the Supreme Lord and the creation of the conditioned soul. Creation of the conditioned soul is a problem. Creation of the Lord has no problem. Me, mine is a problem. Because we have created this thing. So, Srila Prabhupada writes, then Srila Prabhupada is giving a statement, because Srila Prabhupada has spoken a lot on his morning walks, in his conversation, in his letters, and off the record. They are all spoken from the mouth of a pure devotee. But if we have to quote something, ultimately his scripture are the final authority. Because all the other things are in context. All the other things are in reference to some issue. But the scripture is going to live for 10,000 years. Therefore, some scholar says there are 10 commandments in Christianity, still there are so many factions and sections. And Prabhupada has millions of commands. If you don't really streamline those, then you can have so many also branches. Prabhupada said like this, and Prabhupada said like this. Therefore, whatever ultimately, if you have to quote, the books are the final authority. Books are the basis. Other things we have to refer, but in context, not absolute. But the books are absolutely, because these are Prabhupada's. These books are Prabhupada's Buddhi Yogam. Prabhupada said, how you are writing all this? Because Krishna is inspiring me to write, so I am writing this. So these books is the final. So Prabhupada, when he said we are all part and parcel, then Prabhupada is simply giving the information. In Bhagavad Gita 15:7, Lord says, Mamaivanso jiva loke jiva bhuta sanatanaha. The living entities in this conditioned world are my eternal fragment parts. Why the conditional word is bhuta? Mamaiva ansa jiva. Jiva are my ansa. Living entities are my part and parcels. Mamaiva ansa jiva loke. Jiva bhuta. The second word, Krishna is so smart in telling, but these jiva are hunted by bhuta, means ghost. You know, bhuta means ghost in Hindi. And bhuta, what is this ghost? Ghost is five elements by which this body is made, and why I think I am this body, and we forget that we are part and parts of Krishna. This is ghost. What is ghost actually? Ghost means you forget yourself, and then you speak the language of ghost, that is called ghost hunted person. So we are hunted by this bodily identification, and I am this, I am man, I am this. So we are all ghost hunted. So jiva bhuta. Jiva is sanatan and bhuta is sanatan. Both are sanatan. Prakriti purusha. Ubhav, both are eternal. This is a 13th chapter. Prakriti, Purusha, Divav. Both are eternal. Prakriti and Purush, both are eternal. Sanatan. They are existing from beginning. It is like Prabhupada's one comment, boys are good and girls are good as long as they are separate. So jeev is good and bhoot is good if they are separate. If you go to a spiritual world, there is no bhoot. This is all a spiritual body, then is all good. As long as condition means, as long as this ghost, we are hunted with this ghost, means the material body, we have this problem of claiming me and mine. Therefore, the word used by Rupa Goswami is Jivan Mukta. So when we are living, we have to be freed from the bodily concept of life. This is called Jivan Mukta. So Srila Prabhupada writes, the living entities are nothing but very small portion of the Supreme Spirit, like the spark of the fire. Because they are part of the Supreme, they have a creative quality in a very minute quantity. We all have a creative quality, but it's in minute quantity. Okay. Now Srila Prabhupada is writing, the so-called scientists of the modern materialistic world are proud because they have created modern facilities like great aeroplanes. But the credit for creating the aeroplane should go to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, not to the scientists who have invented or created the so-called wonderful products. One person came to see Srila Prabhupada. He came from Calcutta, and he was owner of one cement factory. So when he came to Prabhupada says, "Oh, gentlemen, what are you doing?" He said, "I am cement factory." He said, "How you make cement?" He said, "From the stone." He said, "Who created stone?" He said, "God." He said, "Oh, you are using God's property and claiming you are creator? You are thief. Huh? You are using the stone to make cement from the hills, rock. Who created rock? The man was really embarrassed. He says, God. He says, you are using God's property. You are thief. And he said, therefore, Swamiji, I have come in the temple and I am giving donation. He said, you are a big thief. You are getting more and giving less. So Prabhupada has exposed that. Similar, he said, they have created this aeroplane. That is very good. How many years these two brothers who created the aeroplane? Who are these two brothers? Huh? Bright. Wright brothers, big opulence. Huh? This is their big opulences. Huh? They have many years of and many dollars of expenditure. Ultimately, it came out as an aeroplane. But Prabhupada has a nice, wonderful purport here. There's a good creation, but when it goes in scrap, then there's a much problem and of pollution and so many things. But see the God's creation, there's any pollution? When annihilation, there's nothing left here. So, perfect creation of the Supreme Lord. There's one example given for creation of Supreme Lord is spider. He is not getting anything from outside. From inside him, he takes out saliva, he makes the nice web, and then he float on that. Anybody else go in that, he's caught, but he's not caught. And at the end of the day, he just take everything inside and bye-bye. So this is the creation, is a perfect creation. This is a perfect creation. Prabhupada's purport, we just read. The another good creation is this sun. Is sun going for some charging every day for giving light to us? So much voltage every day sun is giving from millions of lives. It's not recharging, it is self-effulgent. And this is one of the opulence of the minute opulence of the Krishna, which is self-sufficient. It doesn't need anybody's help. Anything, heat or light in this world, ultimately it's coming from sun. It's coming from, diamond has not its own, it's a reflection of that light which is coming from the sun through whatever source. So what a wonderful creation it is. Just if we understand simply these things, then we can just fold our hands, say, Krishna Hari Bol, we are yours. But people don't understand that. They think, why I have created this? This is my creation. There is problem. Okay, the scientists have created this with the intelligence. Who gave the intelligence? Who gave the material? Prabhupada immediately quote, Bhagavad Gita 15:15, Madhasamrtir Jnanam Apohanam Cha. From me comes remembrance, knowledge and forgetfulness. Because the Supreme Lord and Super Soul sit within the core of every living in his heart, the dictation by which one advances in scientific knowledge, our creative faculties come from him. Scientific knowledge, whatever knowledge we have, it is coming from Krishna. A simple example, when you go to the kitchen and cook some halwa, who tells you how much sugar you have to put? Not the salt, put sugar, who tells you this? From inside, Super Soul, as a Krishna, he guides how much you have to put. How we have weight in our homes? Nobody, there is no weight system. Krishna tells and they put and it's perfect. But they think, I have made halwa today. You tested my halwa. What was yours in the halwa? All the ingredients, everything was already existing there. You simply mixed all these things. And why you claim that I am creator? Then what is the credit we should have? This is Bhagavad Gita shloka. We should immediately remember. Nimitta matra bhava savya sachan. Already I have killed all these soldiers, you become instrument and get a credit. So become nimitta matra in the hands of Krishna. This is what Srila Prabhupada, when he landed in America, he said, I am just like a puppet. Krishna, use me as you use. This is a nimitta matra. And then this whole ISKCON created by Krishna through Prabhupada. So become simply the instrument. Don't claim I can do and then you are finished. And those who claim like that, they are no more. Many kings came and their names in history are only, there's nothing left behind. So, Srila Prabhupada says, furthermore, the ingredients to manufacture wonderful machines like aeroplane are also supplied by Lord, not by the scientist. Before the aeroplane was created, its ingredients already existed, having been caused by the Supreme Personality of Godhead. But when the manifested creation of the aeroplane is ruined, the remaining debris is a problem for the so-called creator. It's a problem. That is a problem. You know how difficult it is to wind up every festival? So much problem to wind up the things. But Krishna has to wind up the creation, there's nothing left behind. It's perfect. Purnamada Purnamadam Purnata Purnamudachyate. Everything is completely perfect. Another example is that the waste is creating many automobiles, but now the automobiles are here likely ants in the streets. In India now, in Bombay, you can go by foot more quickly than by vehicle in some part of the Delhi and Bombay. So it's hell now. Even in Vrindavan, in day you want to go to the, in the evening you cannot go to the Lohi Bazaar. By your car it will take 1 hour, by foot it will take half an hour, by rickshaw it may take 25 minutes. But there's no way you can reach anywhere. So much crowd now here. So, the ingredients for these cars are supplied, of course, by the Supreme Lord. And the intelligence for this so-called creation is also supplied by the Lord. Ultimately, when the cars are demolished, the so-called creator faced with the problem of what to do with their ingredients. The actual creator, the original creator, is personality of Godhead. Only in the interim does someone create something with intelligence supplied by the Lord. And later the creation again becomes problem. Therefore, the so-called creator is not to be credited with the act of creation. The only credit goes to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. It is rightly stated here and that the credit for all the appellants of the creation, maintenance, and annihilation belongs to the Supreme Lord, not to the living entity. Here ends the purport by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. So before creation, after creation, there's no problem because everything is within the abdomen of Garbhodakshai Vishnu. So nobody can do anything. But only during creation, we think I have done this. So the only interim, because of the, but this verse always Prabhupada used to quote, Prakriti Kriyamanai Gunahi Karmani. And then what is the word then? Ahankar Vimura Atma Karta Ahamiti Manyate. Vimura Atma. Mura means actually those who are stuck, fools. And Vimura is very special, superlative degree. Vimura Atma Karta Aham Iti Manyate. I am the doer. This is the foolish idea. So, what we learn from today's verse by Chitraketu, a great devotee, a disciple of Narada Rishi, that we may be given some project to accomplish. And Krishna will give intelligence for that to come through successfully. But immediately we remember this verse and said, everything which is accomplished is the mercy of Sri Krishna coming through parampara. So its credit goes to Hari Guru Vaishnavas. I am simply instrument in their hands. I am Das, 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 Anudas. That is our greatest qualification. Is there any qualification more bigger than Gopi Bhartahu Padakamalayor Das, 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 Anudas? No. This is our qualification. If we just focus on this one theme, then all problems will be solved. There's no competition then. Isparda is a word, competition. Isparda means competitive mood. And the other word in the verse is Isparda Pratik. So this separate interest from Krishna is a problem. To be separate enjoyer, to have a separate prestige, to have a separate mentality is a problem. So no competition, but cooperation with Krishna. You become a cooperate with Krishna in his creation, no problem. No competition, cooperation. No separate interest than Krishna. That is the bottom line of this verse. Thank you very much. Time is over. Still, if somebody has some comment. Maharaj, you say something? It's by your mercy. Your presence has inspired me, Maharaj ki jai. Anything else? Anybody has to say something? Granthraj Srimad Bhagavat, Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Thank you very much.